Today is all about making decisions. And right now, I'm going to decide what treat to eat. How will I decide? I'm leaving it up to fate. Heads, I eat this delicious looking brownie. Tails, I eat this glob of mayonnaise. Ooh. Drum roll, please. Woo! It's heads! Thank goodness, I really did not want to eat that glob of mayonnaise. Flipping a coin might be useful occasionally, but as you might have experienced in your preview activity, it can also yield less than optimal results. And this was a very small decision. I barely thought about the possible consequences when I made it. But bigger choices have even bigger consequences. They require more thought and consideration. Fortunately, economists have a better approach to complex decision making, and we're going to let you in on the secret. Hey there, aspiring economists, it's Bea. In today's lesson, we're going to be discussing the cost-benefit analysis. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to answer the following questions. What is a cost-benefit analysis? What are the steps in a cost-benefit analysis? When is a cost-benefit analysis useful? And you should start to think about our big picture question. How can you make the best decisions for you? In our last lesson, you learned about opportunity cost and how you can use the concept to help you evaluate choices. But sometimes we're faced with choices where there's no clear winner, advantage, or better choice in terms of opportunity cost. When that happens, we have to compare how we benefit from each decision. We're going to break down the cost-benefit analysis. It's a comparison of the costs against the benefits of a particular choice. It's not just a pro-con list. With a cost-benefit analysis, you're assigning a value to each cost and benefit that represents how important it is to you. That way, you can see which factors matter more to you personally. This helps you evaluate the options more thoroughly. Does that sound potentially useful? We'll go through an example in the next section, step by step. For now, it's time for your first guiding question. Make sure you pause the video and answer the question in your lesson PDF. What is a cost-benefit analysis? Okay, so now you understand what a cost-benefit analysis is and why it might be more useful than, say, flipping a coin or creating endless lists of pros and cons. But how exactly do you do it? Economists break it down into five basic steps. Step one, identify the decision to be made. So, I've been thinking about maybe getting a part-time job during the school year, you know, to save some cash for college or whatever comes up later on. Now, I'm curious. What do you think a cost-benefit analysis would say about that? Good idea or not so much? All right, let's keep going and find out. Step two, list all possible costs and benefits. Take a moment to look at the list of costs and benefits that I came up with. They're listed on page 5 in your PDF. Did you catch that some of these are opportunity costs? They are things I would have to give up, like time to study for school. That's the beauty of the cost-benefit analysis. It helps us see the whole picture of what we'd be gaining and losing, not just the money part. And now, take a look at the potential benefits I came up with in your PDF. So far, so good, right? At this point, I've basically got myself a pros and cons list. But now is where the magic happens. Step 3, assign values to the costs and benefits. For this step, you can use a scale from 1 to 10, with 1 being low importance and 10 being high importance. Note that you can use whatever rating scale you want, generally speaking. This is just an easy one to try. Now, take a minute to go through all the costs and benefits listed in your PDF. Go ahead and put a value on each one based on how much it matters to you personally. Pause the video for a moment and come back when you're all set. All right. Now, your numbers might be a little different from mine, and that's totally fine. I'm going to plug in my numbers here. So, you can see that I rated the potential impact on my school performance as the most important cost of getting a part-time job, with a score of 8. And earning money got the top spot for benefits, with a 9. But now I'm wondering, how do I weigh the overall costs and benefits against each other? Well, that's step 4. Step 4, compare the total costs and benefits. To figure that out, just sum up the values you gave to each cost and benefit. If you need a moment, hit pause on the video and add up your total scores for both costs and benefits, if you haven't already. For me, the numbers turn out like this. My total costs are 6 plus 8 plus 7 plus 7, which equals 28. My total benefits are 9 plus 8 plus 6 plus 7, which equals 30. So, it looks like my total benefits are a bit higher than my total costs. Now, what should we make of this info? We move on to step 5. Step 5, make a decision based on the comparison. So, in my case, the total benefits, 30, are just a bit more than the total costs, 28. That kind of hints that maybe taking a part-time job could be a good move for me. But since the gap is pretty small, I really need to think about what's most important to me and how the job might affect my school stuff and personal life before I make a final call. How did it go for you? What do you think you would decide based on your results? Did the outcome surprise you? There are lots of ways to make a decision. Economists usually like this approach because it gives you a complete view of how a decision might affect you, both the positives and the negatives. All right, time for your second guiding question. Pause the video and answer the question in your lesson PDF. What are the steps in a cost-benefit analysis? Believe it or not, you probably already do something like this, even if you didn't know what it was called. A cost-benefit analysis is super useful when you're trying to figure out if you should go for a single option, like our part-time job example. But it's also great for comparing multiple choices. Just go through the process for each and then check out the overall totals. Which one has the best benefits-to-cost ratio? That's probably the one you want to pick. This analysis can be especially powerful when you're facing those tough, life-changing decisions. You know, like figuring out what to do after high school. That's the perfect time to use this method and really weigh your options. It's not just for individuals either. Big shot companies can use it to decide what to make or how to price things. And governments can use it when they're setting interest rates, taxes, or regulations. Actually, using cost-benefit analysis is super important for these big-picture decisions because they impact so many people. We all hope that when the government raises or lowers taxes, that they're really weighing the costs and benefits before making a move. Okay, let's take a look at your third and final guiding question. Pause the video and answer the question in your lesson PDF. When is cost-benefit analysis useful? So today, we found out that a cost-benefit analysis is all about comparing the costs and benefits of a specific choice in a market. We went through the five steps of a cost-benefit analysis and worked on an example together. And lastly, we saw that this analysis can be super handy for all sorts of folks. Individuals making small or big decisions, companies figuring out production and distribution, and even governments tackling macro-level choices like setting interest rates or taxes. In our next lesson, we're going to take everything we've learned so far and start to put it into action as we help Mia set up their own business, a lovely lemonade stand. Until next time, this is B, reminding you to keep investing in your future one lesson at a time. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.